This is my garage and it's a mess, and I've done videos here before and it always looks terrible, right? Like, I mean, look at this thing. Looks absolutely terrible. Absolutely terrible, I know. And I do have plans to change this. I am going to spend a little bit of money on this and really try and get this garage a new makeover. So this is what I got here. These cabinets I got for free. So what I'm thinking is putting these cabinets on my garage, and they're wall cabinets and floor cabinets, and they're pretty decent ones. They're in a fairly good shape. So what I plan on doing is using these as arrangements. All right, I am moving all of this stuff out. This is, I have no idea what I'm doing here, but it's a lot of work. Alright guys, I have gotten this thing out. This took forever. I still have to clean up the shelves, but that's a big difference. And actually the garage looks so much bigger with this thing out of here. So the garage has got a slope, and what I have to figure out is the right amount. Now this, most garages do have a slope to them, so when you install cabinets and stuff you have to keep that in mind. Yeah, it's pretty bad here. You can see like that is the, so it needs to come up to here. And what I have are these really old deck boards that I think I'm going to be laying down. They're almost exactly. Then I'll just shim them up. Shim them. All right, I got the first wall cabinet up. I don't know exactly how high it should be, but my idea is that I want some sort of pegboard area here so you can see tools. I don't even need more cabinets. I could just use that wall to put the pegboards. But I think I do have a few more of these cabinets, so I am going to be putting them up on the wall. And I do plan on putting them also in that corner if I can figure out how to do that. So it's a little bit hard by yourself. I finished clearing this part up, all my stuff. This is more my motorcycling stuff, so now I'm gonna slide this shelf out. Yeah, that's that, but now I need more storage. And look at this, I found all of these cabinets for free. I drove all the way to Manassas, which is pretty far, and I have these. So this is a wall cabinet, this is a bottom cabinet, this is a corner cabinet, and these two are the round Lazy Susan ones, which I don't know how to put them anywhere. I think these are base cabinets. I don't know if I'll even use these, but there's always somebody that needs the storage. And then I have this here, which is another wall cabinet. You can see I put all of these cabinets up. All of this stuff I had in the shelves actually fits inside the cabinets, and I still haven't put the top here. These are really good cabinets, by the way. I lucked out. These are much better than what I have. I have more cabinets up on this side of the wall. Now I have even more cabinets that I got for free. By the way, all of these were for free. I got them on Facebook Marketplace and Craigslist. Here are the next slew of cabinets that I'm going to be putting on. They're a little bit darker, they're a little bit cheaper, but I went to get them in Germantown and it works pretty well. I'm really kind of liking this truck. The Nissan Frontier I had, I think I liked it more for general doing stuff, but I don't think I could fit as many cabinets in the Frontier as I can on this big truck. It is howling outside, so it is freezing in the DC area, and I want to show you what I've done so far in the garage. I can fit just about 5 more bikes with the amount of space I have now. So you can see the garage is looking so much better. So far, the cost has been minimal. I got all of these cabinets for free. I got even more cabinets. I got 2 base cabinets. I managed to fit my compressor underneath, so it's tucked out. The one thing I don't have is the countertop yet. So far, this build has cost me less than $100. Because it's been the paint has been the expensive thing, and you can see I have some old paint here, and I will be painting this. I'm not going to paint it this color. What I am going to be doing is painting it almost white, but I'm going to mix in some of this color. So right now I'm about ready to start painting.
Doodang is a funny thing. He got no fins, he got no wing. He got 4 legs that reach the ground, and with those legs he walks around. But the doodang was a bit absurd. He gave his word he'd be a bird, so he took the wings of a big bad crow, and he climbed to the roof, and he said, "Let's go!" And he tried to fly to the sky so high, and he tried, and he tried, and he tried! Goodbye! Be a doodang. Doodang.
All right, guys, here is the garage painted up. Yeah, the coat of paint is drying, but it looks so much better. I mean, it looks like a whole different garage. Now, the color that I mixed in some gray with the white. I kind of wanted it to be white, but I had this leftover whitish gray that I used in a previous job, so I'm still doing like little bits of touch-ups, but that's pretty much it. I don't think I'll be doing more on the wall. The next painting job is going to be the ceiling. But I think I also need to start thinking about the countertops. The countertops are going to be very simple. I'm just going to get wood. They're not going to be any fancy stuff. I might stain it with some sort of wood stain, but that's pretty much it. And yeah. Let's move on with the project. I just picked this up. These are pegboards. And we all know what this does. You know, like, I've never installed these, but they're gonna go right over here in the wall. So look at that, that's a almost perfect fit. So here's another board. I'm gonna see if this one will fit here. Hopefully it will. I'll just have to do like a little bit of some wood to get it. Look at that, it fits perfectly. I forgot one of the cost was $9 for these 6 pairs of rollers. Here we go, here's the nice white paint. And we're gonna get started. got the counter. This wasn't exactly what I wanted, but it was the cheapest option. You know, wood right now, lumber, is pretty expensive. You can get like a very large sheet for $64. This was $40 already cut, and then here's the other one already cut, and it you know, it's pretty durable. This is like laminated wood. So now this is set up. The other option is getting like a board like this that's a little bit thick and putting it on, but I believe that this is going to work out pretty well and automatically makes the garage look so much better. Welcome to the new garage, guys. It is freezing out. You know, this garage took me a while to do, and you know, I'm still not done, but I figure I'd show you the status of it. So check this out. This is the main part, still not done. Remember, it's kind of a mess. Organizing things is a little bit difficult for me, but yeah, like I think in total I spent about $450 on this garage build, but I'm pretty happy with it. So here I have another little workspace, and man, it is just freezing out. I think it's like 19 degrees out here in the DC area, but yeah, these cabinets, I got them all for free. And I had, of course, all of this stuff. I painted the walls, I got the pegboards, I got all my stuff here. These are mostly tools, but I'm trying to organize and clean things up. One of the big expenses was the counter. I got a $80 counter, and here we go. These cabinets are extremely good, and I got them for free. They were going to be thrown away, and I believe even used, they're like $1,000, I think. But really good solid wood, and these are decent but not as good. You can tell right away the quality, and I have plenty of storage. And then I got another set of cabinets that I got for free. The compressor actually fits down here, so it's kind of out of the way, and if I want, I can remove it and kind of have like a desk there and sit and work. So I'm kind of like trying to figure things out so it's not such a big mess. This stuff, I plan on buying something for the garage because there's plenty of room above there. So there's these racks that you can buy and then put stuff up on the ceiling. So I plan on doing that. In my garage, I have the Tenere. I'm about to take it for a spin, just because it's the only bike that has heated, you know, vest hookups. I got the NC, I got the 1985 Elite 150, I got the SH150, and the Elite 110. I am not gonna lie, it is a little bit of a mess of bikes. I don't like to have too many bikes in my garage, so I am hoping to sell some of these coming in spring. So today is definitely not the time to sell bikes, but it is a good time to buy bikes. So I'm also looking for bikes to buy so I can ride in the spring. But I intend on selling, I think I am going to sell the NC700, just because when you have the Super Tenere, it is just so much more fun to ride than the NC. And I like the NC a lot. Like, it's got a lot of stuff going for it, but when you compare it to the Super 10, right, there's no, like that's the bike I like riding the most. I like riding the scooters, but I like riding the scooters to the city and just kind of joy riding them. The NC is great as a commuter, but I don't commute full time. $100 something, you know, if you have a pickup truck like this, you can go and pick up cabinets for free. You know, when you live in the DC area, there's an abundance of wealth, so people throw away perfectly good stuff. So that's pretty much it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. I'm stuck here. The cops won't bother me.